My name is Rosemary, founder of Techable Assistive Technology. In my previous video, I showed you how to control an iPhone with a trackball or touchpad. And I've covered the basic features of the assistive touch. So today, I'd like to show you how to control an iPad with head mouse. And I'm going to cover the dual control feature and the custom gesture under the assistive touch. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so let me start with how to create a custom gesture. So you first need to go to settings and go to accessibility, and then under physical and motors, select touch. And if you look under here, there is the first button is assistive touch. So you tap assistive touch and go into settings of assistive touch. So the custom gestures, it's right here under custom gestures. There is create new gesture button. So let me explain to you what kind of gesture that I'm going to make. So if I control the iPad by touch, then when I read an email, if there is a message that I like to delete, what I do is I swipe from right to left on the message and delete the message. So like this. So the message is deleted. So that gesture, swipe from right to left, I'm gonna create that as custom gesture. So later I can use it with head mouse. So let me go back to setting and accessibility. Touch, assistive touch, and then I'm going to tap create new gesture. And here I'm going to swipe to create my own custom gesture. So like that. And then I'm going to save it by pressing the button at the top right corner. And then it's going to ask me the name for this new gesture. So I'm going to name it delete. Okay, and then tap save. So now you can see under custom gesture, the gesture that I just created, delete, is created. And I'll show you using this gesture after I connect the head mouse to the iPad. But I like to point out that when I go up and turn on the assistive touch, and as you can see at the bottom, the assistive touch button is shown on the screen, and if I open it, the custom gesture that I just created is under custom, and here you can see that delete gesture that I created, it's shown on here. Okay, then I'm gonna tap and go out, and let me scroll down, and then to use the head mouse with iPad, you need to turn on this dual control feature. So dual control, it's very similar to the dual feature, which I've covered in the head control mouse video. So if a pointer is stopped on a button or icon for a certain period of time, the button or the icon opens, it's activated. And if you look at all the way at the bottom, you can adjust the amount of time you need to point and wait to activate the button. So I'll adjust it to 2 seconds. So the pointer needs to be on the icon for 2 seconds to activate it. Okay, and for the fallback action feature, I'll come back to it after I connect the head mouse to explain how it works. And then let's look at the movement tolerance. So if I go into the movement tolerance, this will let you adjust the distance you can move while dwelling on an item. So for example, if the user tends to shake his or her head while using the head mouse, so the movement tolerance can be set to large by sliding all the way to the right. So even though the head shakes and the pointer moves, that item can still be activated. And I'll set up around here. Okay, and then let me go back to assistive touch. And then right below the movement tolerance, there is hot corners feature. So let me go into the hot corners. It is very convenient feature. As written here, if you dwell at a corner of each screen, it performs an action you predefined in here. So let me set up the bottom right corner as home button. So if I move my pointer to the bottom right and then wait 2 seconds, it's gonna do the same action as pressing home button. And then let me go back. And then I'm going to define the bottom left corner as, let me see, tap. So when I stay at the bottom left corner, it's gonna do the tap. Okay, I'm gonna go back. And then let me go back to assistive touch. So now let me turn on the dwell control. And as I showed you on my previous video, I'm going to connect this USB head control mouse to iPad using the connector, the USB to Lightning connector. And then I'm going to plug it in. So the camera light is now on, and I'm gonna move close to me. And then I'm going to put one of this reflective sticker on my forehead. And then you can see the pointer now appears on the screen, and the camera sees the reflective dots and it's control this pointer. Okay, so now let me go to assistive touch button and then home. So this takes me to the home screen. As you can see here, while I'm talking, that dwell time counter is keep spinning, and this can be pretty distracting, especially when you try to read something. So now let me go back and explain to you how to use the fallback action feature to make pause dwell counter after it takes each action. So let me cover my reflective dot, and then I'm gonna go to settings and accessibility, touch, assistive touch, and then under here, under dwell control, there is fallback action feature. So I'm going to tap and go in, and the fallback action It says it reverts to your preferred action after performing an operation. So I'm gonna set it as pause dwell. So what it's gonna do is it's gonna pause dwell after it takes each action. So pause dwell, and then I'm gonna turn on the fallback action. So now let me open assistive touch button and then choose home. And now, as you can see here, after it takes me to the home page, the dwell time counter, it doesn't spin anymore. Okay, so if I want to click and open this mail app, what I need to do is go to Assistive Touch and then go to Dwell. And then I can resume Dwell. So I'm going to go to Mail. And then it opens. But as you can see here, after it opens the Mail app, the Dwell counter doesn't spin anymore because of the fallback action feature kicked in. So in here, of course, if I want to choose one of this mail, I can always resume dwell action, but I can also use the hot corner feature, which I've set up while I set up the one of the assistive touch feature. So I've set up this left corner as tap. So if I move mouse pointer to the left, bottom left corner and dwell there for 2 seconds, it's gonna do the tap action. So let me show you how it works. Okay, so now the tap action kicked in. And if I move pointer to one of the email, it's gonna open the email by tapping it. And again, the fallback action kicks in and dwell time counter doesn't show. So let me now show you how to use the custom gesture which I've created. So let me delete this gap flash sale email by using the gesture. So I'm going to go to assistive touch and then custom and then delete custom gesture, and then I'm going to move my mouse here. And as you can see here, it does that right to left swiping gesture, and then it deleted that email. Let me show you one more time. And that's how it works. And finally, I've set up the right lower corner as home button for the hot corner setup. So let me use that hot corner to perform that action. So I'm going to move my pointer to the right lower corner. And then now it activated the home button. Okay, so today I've shown you how to use that dwell feature and also how to create custom gesture to use iPad connected with head mouse. That's all I have for today. Thank you for watching.